Hello, Apple Valley High School students. This is part two of our Fab Lab Machines tour. I'm going to start out with our vacuum form. It costs about $1,000. And what this does is it will take sheets of plastic like this, and it'll actually heat them up to they're almost liquid. So they're real kind of stretchy. So you heat it up and then you flip it over. And then you put an object here that you want to create a mold out of, and then this will get pulled down by the fan that's underneath it. Materials that we use are these plastic sheets, and primary use is for making molds. A lot of people will 3D print stuff and then use the 3D printed object as the device to create the mold with the plastic. Next up is our UV printer. Really cool machine, very expensive. It's about a $40,000 machine. And what it does is it will print ink onto anything that you put into the build space. So primary use is for printing onto objects. You'll notice that there are six different types of ink that it uses. So that's the material that it uses. And then the build space is about 20 inches by 13 inches by about 4 inches tall. So here's an example of something that was printed. So this, you can kind of see that if I get a good background, that flower was printed on there with the UV printer. Really neat machine. And we're gonna use Adobe Illustrator to set stuff up with that. Next up on our tour of machines is our 250MC 3D printer. That machine is a production level 3D printer. It was donated to us by Stratasys. It is a $45,000 machine. We have one of them. Primary materials that it uses are ABS plastic and a dissolvable material. And the two materials are in these cartridges, and they cost about 10 times the price of the MakerBot filament. So the MakerBot filament, those are about $50 a roll, maybe $40 when they're on sale. And the stuff for the Fortis is about 10 times the cost. So this machine is a production level 3D printer. They use these in the industry to actually make real parts for cars and for other machines. Pretty cool device. Next up on our tour is our Isense 3D scanner. We have two of those. And what those are used for are scanning objects and creating a 3D scan of an object. So I have it on an iPad, and the scanner is actually this portion here. Costs about $500. The software for it used to be free, but then they started charging for the software, which is kind of a bummer. Primary, it doesn't really use any materials. Primary use is for taking real objects and turning them into three-dimensional objects. Next up is our Cnc router. This is a pretty expensive machine. It costs about $35,000. It's a 4-foot by 8-foot ShopBot. ShopBot is the brand, so that's the name of the company that makes them. They're out of Georgia. And what this machine will do is it will cut just about any kind of a material except for metals. We don't have a cooling way to cool the spindle or the cutter when it's cutting metal. So we don't cut metal with this. Here's what the bit looks like. This is called a single head. The more expensive machines, you can actually have multiple heads, so it'll rotate through the different heads. It's a pretty loud machine when it's running. It's a really fun one to run. We use this mainly in our advanced class. So once you take Fab Lab Essentials, you can take the advanced class and learn how to use the ShopBot or Cnc router. Primary materials that it uses, anything but metals, we can cut. and it'll do two-dimensional cuts and three-dimensional cuts too. Next up is our soldering station. And our, actually, I'm gonna go to our desktop mills so that you can see these. We have two of them. And what they do, they're kind of like, I would kind of compare them to the 3D printers, but instead of them building up material, they actually cut it away. So they have a cutting head just like the ShopBot has. These cost about $5,000 each. You can cut just about any material. You can even do some soft metals, but again, it doesn't have a cooling system, so we don't usually cut anything, but anything but metals we'll cut with our desktop mills. Next up is our soldering station, and this was donated, the money was donated to put this in. It's about $3,000. We have four different stations when they're up and running. Little bit cluttered right now from building drones last March. Primary materials that we use are wires, solder. We can do electronics work. It's pretty neat. So it adds a really good part to our lab. Next up is our Form 2 and Form 3 3D printers. We have one of each. We got these as a package deal. This is the Form 2. That's the older version. This is the Form 3. This is the upgraded version. Brand new, these cost probably, I think the Form 3 is about $7,000 and the Form 2 was about $5,000. But we got a package deal for them for about $10,000. That was with money that was donated through our grant program by some of our STEM partners. These use a resin material. This is what the resin looks like in the resin tank. So you can kind of see that. It's kind of sticky stuff. The resin gets cured by laser light. So it's pretty neat to see them running. Major difference between the Form 2 and the Form 3 is the Form 3 is faster. It can use different, more materials. It kind of sets up the file more efficiently than the Form 2. Let's see, next up on our tour is our embroider machine. So I'm gonna walk back through to the design portion of our lab. That's where all our desks are. And then I'm gonna come over to the production side. We just left the manufacturing side. And this is our embroidery machine. It's a professional level industry standard. It's called a Baradan. And it's a 15 thread. So there are 15 different threads at once. 15 needles, it's got a single head to it. And this costs brand new $17,000. It's a pretty impressive machine when it's running. This hat, the eagle, was embroidered using this machine. So we can embroider on all kinds of different materials. The main materials that it uses are thread, and there's a backing material. Just wanted to show you this. This is an example of something that we can do with our embroidery machine. So we can embroider on shirts, just about anything that you can put into the jig for this machine. Pretty cool machine. All right, that's about it. So hope you enjoyed that quick tour. Make sure you fill out the two forms, part one and part two, for the Fab Lab tour, and that's it for the assignment. Have a nice day.